The Samsung Galaxy Note 20 is gonna be the smaller device coming in with a 6.42-inch OLED display at a resolution of 2345 by 1080 which gives us 404 pixels per inch. There's a lot of conflicting leaks when it comes to refresh rates, with many claiming the smaller Note 20 is going to come with a 60Hz screen and many others claiming it will be a 120Hz display. It's going to have an aspect ratio of 19.5:9, be protected by Gorilla Glass 6, and it is of course a full screen display with an in-display fingerprint scanner and punch hole selfie camera. We still haven't had confirmation on a sensor that's going to be used for the selfie camera, but many are speculating that it will be the 10 megapixel sensor that we're used to seeing. When it comes to the rear, we've got a quad camera setup on the standard Note 20. It's a 12 megapixel main, a 64 megapixel telephoto, a 12 megapixel ultra wide, and a 3D timer flight depth sensor. Powering the phone is going to be the new Snapdragon 865 Plus in North America and a couple of other regions globally. However, it will of course be the Exynos. There's many claims suggesting that it could be the Exynos 992, which is a 5 nanometer chipset, but personally, I just don't think this is correct. Samsung are most likely going to be saving the 992 for the S21 and give us the 990 or at least an overclocked version in the Note 20. Being the smaller version, it's expected to come with 8GB of RAM and 256GB storage, which is the same as its predecessor, and this seems plenty for such a powerful device. It's going to be powered by a 4300mAh battery with 25W fast charge support, but there's unfortunately gonna be no 3.5mm headphone jack. It's gonna have Bluetooth 5, Wi-Fi 6, and come with Android 10 in the form of One UE 2.5, and it will of course be 5G compatible. The Galaxy Note 20 is going to be up 68 water resistant. It will of course come with the S Pen, and when it comes to pricing, although nothing's been confirmed, we're expecting a launch price of around 999. Next up, we've got the Samsung Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. The Note 20 Ultra is of course the largest model of the two, coming with a 6.9-inch OLED display at a resolution of 3096 by 1444. This gives us 497 pixels per inch, and it is of course a 120Hz display. The Galaxy Note 20 Ultra is going to be a full-screen display with an in-display fingerprint scanner and a punch-hole selfie camera. The display is going to be protected by Gorilla Glass 6. While we haven't had it confirmed, we are hoping that the Note 20 Ultra is going to allow users to run 120Hz at the full Quad HD Plus resolution. When it comes to the rear of the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra, we again have the rectangular camera housing and a quad camera setup. The main camera is a 108 megapixel wide angle with an aperture of f1.8. It's got phase detect, autofocus, laser autofocus, and optical image stabilization. We get a 13 megapixel telephoto lens with an aperture of f3.5. For this has phase detect, autofocus, optical image stabilization, and it's a periscope lens capable of 5x optical zoom. Get a 12 megapixel ultra wide with an aperture of f2.2, and again this has phase detect, autofocus, and finally we get the additional laser focus sensor. The camera setup is very similar to the S20 Ultra, but given the focusing issues that had, they've replaced the timer flight sensor with the laser focus. They've also got rid of the 100x space zoom, as it was a bit of a gimmick and not much use to consumers, and they've now put a 50x cap in place. The Note 20 Ultra, powered by the Snapdragon 865 Plus in the Snapdragon regions and the Exynos 990 or the 992 globally, it's going to come with 12GB of RAM and a choice of 256 or 512 internal storage. It's going to be powered by a larger battery. While the capacity hasn't been confirmed, it's expected to be between 4500 and 5000 mAh. Again, we've got no 3.5mm headphone jack, but it will have Bluetooth 5, Wi-Fi 6, 5G connectivity, and be up 68 water resistant. It's going to come with the S Pen and a new pointer feature, and while earlier leaks suggest that it would be called the Galaxy Note 20 Plus, we now know from Certification that it's the Note 20 Ultra, so no pricing leaks have come forward yet, but many leakers have suggested it's going to be their most expensive yet. It's expected to be more than the S20 Ultra, so a launch price of at least $1,450 could be on the cards. Both Note 20s are going to be launched alongside other smartphones at the online-only Unpacked event on the 5th of August for those wanting to tune in. It's going to be broadcast on Samsung.com as well as Samsung YouTube channel. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, smash the thumbs up. If you didn't, hit the thumbs down twice. I am Arjun. This is Digital Outside. I will catch you in the next one.